Welcome to Pharmacology Insights, where we break down complex pharmacology into simple, easy-to-understand concepts. Caffeine, your daily pick-me-up. Adderall, a prescription powerhouse. Both boost alertness, but the way they do it couldn't be more different. Today, we'll break down the pharmacology of caffeine versus Adderall, their similarities, the differences, and why one belongs in your coffee mug and the other in your prescription bottle. At first glance, caffeine and Adderall seem like cousins. Both can make you feel more awake, focused, and ready to take on the day. But under the surface, they work on different neurotransmitters, brain circuits, and have different safety profiles. Think of caffeine as a gentle nudge to your brain's wake-up button, and Adderall as slamming the throttle to full speed ahead. The difference matters, especially when it comes to medical use, side effects, and risks. Let's start with caffeine. Pharmacologically, caffeine is an adenosine receptor antagonist. But before we go any further, let's look at how sleep is regulated. As neurons burn energy throughout the day, they produce adenosine, a natural byproduct of cellular metabolism. The more active and alert you are, the more adenosine accumulates in your brain. Adenosine binds to two main types of adenosine receptors, A1 and A2A, located in regions such as the basal forebrain and striatum. Think of adenosine as your brain's sleep pressure gauge. As adenosine builds up, it sends a message to the brain indicating you need to rest. Here's how it works. While you're awake, arousal systems, influenced by factors like motivation, stress, and hunger, help keep you alert. But as adenosine levels climb, A2A receptors in the nucleus accumbens begin to suppress arousal. This process opens the sleep gate, making it easier for you to drift off to sleep. Once you're asleep, A1 receptors step in. Their activation slows neuronal firing and boosts slow-wave activity, or SWA, during slow-wave sleep, a deep non-REM sleep that is essential for memory consolidation, cellular repair, and metabolic waste clearance. By morning, adenosine levels drop, the pressure resets, and you're ready to go again. In short, A2A receptors help decide when you fall asleep by lowering arousal, while A1 receptors decide how restorative your sleep will be by enhancing deep sleep. Both rely on adenosine. The longer you're awake, the more it builds, and the stronger the call to sleep. Then caffeine shows up. It slips into the brain and blocks both A1 and A2A receptors. But its most potent wake-promoting effect comes from blocking A2A receptors, which keeps the sleep gate firmly shut. That means the time-to-sleep signal never gets through. The deep sleep drive is weakened. And wake-promoting neurotransmitters, such as dopamine, acetylcholine, and norepinephrine, keep firing. Importantly, caffeine doesn't directly flood your brain with those wake-up neurotransmitters. It just stops your brain's shut-off systems from working. That's why caffeine's effects are generally mild compared to stimulants like amphetamines, and why you can grab it at any cafe without a prescription. Adderall, on the other hand, contains a mix of amphetamine salts, dextroamphetamine and levoamphetamine, both potent central nervous system stimulants. Amphetamines work mainly by increasing monoamine neurotransmitters released from nerve endings, including dopamine and norepinephrine, and they do this in a few clever ways. First, amphetamines are structurally similar to these neurotransmitters, so they can slip inside neurons using the same transporter proteins, namely dopamine transporter, or DAT, and norepinephrine transporter, or NET. Once inside, they flip these transporters into reverse. Instead of pulling neurotransmitters back into the neuron, DAT and NET push dopamine and norepinephrine out into the synapse. Amphetamines enter storage vesicles through the vesicular monoamine transporter, or VMAT2, displacing dopamine and norepinephrine into the cytoplasm, ready for release. By binding to DAT and NET, amphetamine also blocks these transporters from clearing neurotransmitters out of the synapse. The result is a rapid and sustained rise in dopamine and norepinephrine levels in key brain areas. dopamine heightens reward, motivation, and persistence in tasks. In the prefrontal cortex, it improves working memory. Norepinephrine sharpens alertness and focus, activating brain regions such as the locus coeruleus to filter distractions. That's exactly what's needed in ADHD and narcolepsy, where these signaling pathways are underactive. But because Adderall acts directly on dopamine reward circuits, the same ones targeted by addictive drugs, it carries a risk of misuse and dependence. It can also cause significant cardiovascular side effects. So, both are stimulants, but caffeine blocks adenosine while Adderall increases dopamine and norepinephrine release. Caffeine is mild, but Adderall is potent and targeted. You can get caffeine over the counter, while Adderall is a prescription only and controlled. Too much caffeine can cause jitteriness, insomnia, and palpitations. Too much Adderall can cause high blood pressure, arrhythmia, anxiety, or even psychosis. For most people, caffeine's effects taper off in a few hours. Adderall's effects can last much longer, and misuse can have serious consequences. Caffeine and Adderall may both make you feel more awake, but they're playing very different pharmacological games. One is a safe daily stimulant for most healthy adults, the other is a powerful medical tool with strict prescribing rules. Understanding how they work isn't just interesting, it's a reminder that not all stimulants are created equal. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.